one tournament to the next. They're both going to jump up a spot.
We hope
at least.
You're enjoying your afternoon here on pitch two. Your match commentator Pete Stark.
Yeah, look, we've spoken before about what's going on with England and trying to understand why they haven't been performing to what we know that they can. And we want to see this team be competitive. We want to see them playing to their potential, because when they can, my God, they're really competitive. We want to see those top eight. We know that they can be in top four, but they haven't been. We've seen glimpses of that more so yesterday than today. So rock on for them.
England against Russia for fifth place at the Dubai Sevens. England away off the boot of Holly Aitchison. Ball taken down. That sun is causing some tricky issues on the restart. But they do eventually bring it to ground and set away with first possession to attack. And already getting it out wide to Mikhaltseva. And she's going to take them on the outside, getting around the outside, coming back at her again as Fleming missed initially and then drives it aground. Good chase back by Fleming, not giving up on the tackle and forcing the turnover as well. And England might try to break away from just inside their own half.
Knock on advantage, Blue.
Ball goes forward off the hand, so advantage for Russia.
Advantage over.
Russia get the turnover ball.
And again, they stretch out to the right where the skipper is still standing. Little goose step. And again, a good tackle to bring down Kukina. Another knock on. Ball stripped away. So Aitchison sets away for England. What a ball she's able to pop. And the hands are there from Abby Brown. And again, another ball for Roland. Aitchison back pedals. And her team goes with her. Probing for an opening. Brown and Fleming. She's the speedster. A real flyer in the England side. Trying to suck in the Russian defence. Ball goes through the hands, working their way through the middle and now to ground. Tidied up by Yeren and creates an overlap too for Matthews around the outside. Hummed over. Tracking across to bring Alex Matthews down and a penalty, holding on too long.
Oh, England be disappointed with that turnover. They did really, really well to get the ball back. There was some really good continuity through the centre. Then they slow it down to reset to get their players back. But again, just a sloppy pass by Aitchison. Eventually it got to Alex Matthews, but turnover and possession back with Russia. So a bit of tit for tat at the moment. Nobody kind of breaking stride or breaking dominance yet.
Hey, we're playing between the 22s. Now we head back to halfway for a throw by Russia. We'll need to be very accurate here. It is breezy. See the flags fluttering. And they're on the money to the front with Hamidova. Mikhaltseva on the charge. Again, that wraparound play out to the left and trying to skip through, but it's a good tackle by Yurin again on Kukina. Running out of room, Lushina. Too many white jerseys around, so they switch the point of attack through Baranchuk. Mikhaltseva, good continuity here by Russia. Prudkina, Hamidova. One way, then the other. Back in again.
Russia against England.
Ball still sitting there for Russia. Driven back and a good tackle. Good defence. Was able to slip a little ball somehow to Lushina though. Good effort from Prudkina. And that sets Hamidova away down the right.
Six roll!
England just hassling Russia at the moment, but they've given away a penalty. Fleming was meant to roll. I'm not sure where she could roll, but anyway.
Yeah, England were maintaining really good shape and defence there. Russia needed to penetrate. They were just standing off. England weren't doing an awful lot. They weren't even making big tackles. So Russia need to identify that punch forward to suck them in and try and create some form of decision by England. Either way, there's a turnover back on. That's Russia's side.
Time off. Sub.
Kick goes down over the 10-metre line.
Time is off.
Yes. Abby Burton, the 18-year-old who made her debut in Glendale last month, trots on in number three.
Okay. Time on.
Deborah Fleming, who comes to the side, but Hamidova is there. Hamidova accelerates away the long legs and the big strides of Bizant Hamidova, and Russia break the deadlock to score in the first half.
Breaks the deadlock, so it's Russia. After a 5-point lead.
A really important try by Hamidova, the ever-present Hamidova, first name on the team sheet. She just rangy player, reaches up in the line-out, spots a space in the line-out and just pops herself through. An important try for Russia to break the deadlock. Russia's top try scorer overall, 85 tries now at this stage.
Fabulous conversion as well. So Russia go ahead 7-0 with 2 minutes to play in the first half.
Well, the machine is slotting the extras, so just under 2 minutes to go. Advantage Russia, 7-0 over England.
Long with the kickoff this time. Heaved downfield and taken nicely by Roland above her head.
Roland.
Here is Burton, back to Roland.
Looking for opportunities on this short side, but
Brown
to be had. Loose ball.
And now the turnover ball in the hands of Russia. Our advantage was just over and had gone back into England hands, but just a couple of little knock-ons. Tired late in the tournament now, and it gives Russia another good attacking threat.
Yeah, England won't be happy with that. Roland and Burton, the subs that have just come on, just a little bit messy there with just getting out of their 22, yeah, just their exit. Turnover to Russia, who equally didn't do a good job of it, but either way, it's Russia's possession in a really, really good attacking position now.
Set.
Options either side.
James Bailey, the coach, and his bench watch on as the team on the field has to defend, and it was a quick ball to McCaltsover. Can't link up with Rakova, though, and she's furious with herself. Elena Mikhaltseva, ball just too far in front of Zrakova.
Line out or scrum?
It was a burst of speed, wasn't it?
Yeah, and it was a dead set try. Really nice platform in the centre of the pitch. Mikhaltseva, she saw where the overlap love. I'm sure they would have tried to predict that and play it. And just that last hand, oh, last pass didn't go to hand. They're going to be really frustrated with that.
She'd usually back herself, Lynn.
Yeah, true that, true that. Yeah, being an honourable captain to put her Drakova away in the outside.
Bind. Stay in. Set.
England still hard pressed against their own line though, so opt to stab that kick through and turn Drakova around. They do not want to give this woman any room. She is out and out pace. They round on her, but she gets the ball away to Lushina, who I think was considering just kicking it into Tajwar Hamidova. She does exactly that. It was getting a little bit messy for Russia. They were heading backwards, so let's safely get to the halftime break. And it's Russia with a slim advantage, 7-0 in the playoff for fifth.
7 points to nothing lead over England.
So you can't hear me? Can you hear me, Godfrey? Can you hear me? Okay. So he's out.
final words for England. Got to find something. Crush it. Just within noses in front. 7 points to nil at the break.
Yeah, both teams seem lethargic, Ricky. Understandably in this heat and this stage in the competition. So.
Sorry to distract you there, Liv.
Exactly. But I suppose that's just the nature of the beast. And these last final games, like we said the last time, are the most important ones. They're the ones that dictate your position. Really, really important for England to get this fifth place position. Important for Russia equally because of the bad start that they had. If they could come away with this fifth position, really, really impressive for them. But who knows? It's literally game on at this stage. 7-0.
Referee does blow. Game on. Second half underway between Russia and England.
Well played by England.
England. Spin the ball out wide to their speedster and Breach. Hummed over, looks after her well. Nicely kept in though by England. Good support by Brown and Burton. Real wrestle at ruck time. They can't quite get over there. Gee, we're close. And Breach is tapped and gone quickly, trying to use his speed to catch them off guard. Kildun had made a run, didn't get the ball though. And so Aitchison spinning one way and the other, and now she does find Ellie Kildun, who was there in support. She checked her run, went back and re-offered herself, and Ellie Kildun scores to equalise for England.
It's Ellie Kildun who adds the first
Aitchison
score.
Creation of space there was absolutely outstanding and exactly what England needed. She did so, so well. She just delayed that pass. She was going to go over the top. She messed around with the defence in the midfield, created enough space. And Ellie Kildun, look, what a bright future. We've spoken about her so many times. She cuts these absolutely blistering lines and has blistering pace to back it up to get a really, really important try to get England on the board and the first try of the second half.
Try is converted from out in front, so England back on terms, 7 points to nil. And they've got a real fine in that young woman in jersey 8. 7 points all, excuse me, is back on terms.
Make sure you kick behind the line.
Thanks. Aitchison, who created it, and that's into the wind. And that's not going to go very far at all, curling backwards. So Russia will reset on halfway.
So we momentarily restarted.
Yeah, we've spoken about the poor restart stats in Dubai in general. And again, we haven't heard from the players themselves to say if it's down to anything in particular. But England would be very, very disappointed at that. The worst thing you can do, the last thing you want is when you score a great try to break momentum back on your half is to make a mistake like that to give it back to Russia.
Sheena on the wraparound, and that's a great flat ball onto the chest of Zrudkova, and there's no stopping Elena Zrudkova from there. Beautifully worked move by the Russians.
Elena Drakova against Jess Breach. Jess Breach is lightning. Drakova is even faster. She was the top try scorer in Dubai last year. Really nice, well worked. This is just off the training pitch. And again, in response to that missed kick by Aitchison, that has really, really punished England.
Kicks away. Elena Drakova started this weekend on the bench. Been in the starting seven the last couple of matches, and she's absolutely punished England there with her pace. 12 points to 7, Russia lead. Ball allowed to bounce, and that's going to leave England tracking back. Wilson Hardy does well to regather. Aitchison again. He's able to skip away from at least one defender. Now Breach trying to take on Hamidova on the outside, and does it well. Hamidova coming back at her. She's got Lashina sweeping across. Breach going in and out, eyeing up Daria Lashina. Goes one way, and the covering tackle comes across from Mikaltseva, but it's a brilliant breakout by Breach. Penalty Russia.
Number three.
1, 2, 3 errors by England, one after the other. Absolutely beautiful break by Breach. I think she could have gone her own way or gone the whole way herself, but she slowed up. And again, then Russia did so well to get back in defence, in support, to turn the ball over. Back possession back in Russia's half. And you get the sense that momentum is shifting back to Russia in this first half of the second half.
Ringing the changes. Taking the field.
Okay, thanks.
Cook over. Onto the field in place of Kukina for Russia. Natasha Hunt out there as well now for England.
Time on.
Fleming waiting to get her re-entry back into the match too. So Hunt is the one tracking back. As the kick is skewed into touch.
Yeah, here we see the absolutely brilliant break by Breach. She is so, so fast. She steps back inside, she swifts her arms, and again, I think if she had to put the afterburners on up here, she would have got her, because Oshina would have lost her legs, but it's such a great try. But Milkova, again, just a try, or just a saviour for Russia, once again.
Coming over, the money ball from the line out in the middle, and here is Mikhaltseva, and Rudkova. Rather, there's Mikhaltseva there, puts the ball to ground, just slightly in front of it. England wanted to play on, but the knock on, they'll need to set the scrum.
From the knock on. Still a couple of minutes to go in this game. Still advantage Russia. Only 5 points.
Crouch.
Scrum for England, just on the Russian side of halfway. What can they do from deep? Kildan. One on one with Mikhaltseva, and the Russian captain rides the youngster into the ground. Again, recycling. Ball just ahead of Breach and Fleming bobbling away. A lot of rugby being played on this pitch, too. Might be just starting to get a little uneven, cut up again. Pretty great conditions, though.
Yeah, Deborah Femling's going to be really, really disappointed with that knock on. It was an important one with. How much time do we have left in the clock? Again, Natasha Hunt just skip pass to Deb Fleming, who just came on, so she was relatively fresh to knock it on to give possession back to Russia. Disappointing for England.
Into the final minute of the match now, and Russia could seal the deal if they can grab one here into England territory. Lushina swings it across to Rudkova, trying to get on the outside, but goes back through the middle instead. Still there for Rudkova, now laid back.
Play the ball.
Lucky not to give away a penalty there, England. As Brukina cuts back in again. And now Hamidova stops. It's almost like rope-a-dope there. But Fleming just stayed with her, and eventually they all got to ground. But Unchuk clears. Mikhaltseva. Mikhaltseva will always take on the line, stands in the tackle, some tired bodies in the last match of the weekend for England and Russia. Russia looking to seal it.
Russia content to ship the
going backwards here. Oh, Kukova, and now Hamidova. England trying to hustle, waiting for the hooter, and finally it came. The final minute took an eternity for Russia, but they finish really strongly. And it's Russia who take fifth place in Dubai with a 12-7 win over England.
It is Russia who take fifth.